All right, guys. It's a long time in the making to do this video. This is going to be, after I don't know how many years now, gameplay of my sort of games, Silent Hill 2 video, and it's never quite gone the way I want it to go. So I'm gonna dive into it like I did Bioshock, and we'll see how it goes. And I'm again, you know, with in terms of like the number of parts and all that, I do apologize for splitting up the video as I end up doing quite a bit. Where's that noise thing? It's just that, you know, unfortunately, because of the time limitation. How do I go back now? You know, I have to split it up. Man, it's been a long time. So Born from a Widow. Okay, this is the Greatest Hits version, by the way. So the original version does not have the sub-scenario Born from a Wish. That is the Maria. You can play as Maria, I believe. It's been a long, long, long time. I mean, it's been at least 6 years since I've touched this game. So, I mean, we'll go with normal and we'll go with easy because I really hate the riddles. But yeah, this game, I mean, you know, a lot of people really love this game. I'm going to see if it holds up, because there's a lot of things. I mean, you know, back in the day, for the time, this was amazing. I'm going to shut up and let you guys watch this, because this is really how it sucks you in. The story, more than anything, is what this game is really amazing at. This is the only thing that really bothers me about the game is the wonky controls. I mean, Konami sort of, I'm pretty sure, ported over a lot of their control structure and gameplay from the Resident Evil series, which, you know, as you guys know, I really hate this controls. What the fuck is the blue thingy? It still works. I mean, I'm just getting my bearings here. Is there a blue thingy somewhere? Now, mind you, I've played through this game at least, I think, three. I've gotten about three endings over the time that I've played it. So this is one of those games where you can play it again and again. You get a different ending. And if you're really into it, you'll take the time to play it. But it does take some time. I love the music in this game. Highly recommend the soundtrack if you can find it.
In my restless dreams, I see that town, Silent Hill. You promised you'd take me there again someday, but you never did. Well, I'm alone there now, in our special place, waiting for you.
Letter. The name on the envelope said, Mary. My wife's name. It's ridiculous. Couldn't possibly be true. That's what I keep telling myself. A dead person can't write a letter. Mary died of that damn disease 3 years ago. So then, why am I looking for her? What could she mean? This whole town was our special place. Does she mean the park on the lake? We spent the whole day there. Just the two of us, staring at the water. Could Mary really be there? Is she really alive? Waiting for me?
So, it sets up the game for us. The whole premise, of course, is that your wife is dead. This is James Sunderland, the main character. Something, you know, eerie about the game that always kind of hit me when I first started playing it was the character's name, James. I mean, my name is James. So there was a kind of like eerie connection, you know, when the game's actually saying your name and stuff. It's, you know, you kind of put yourself, it's a lot easier to dive into the character. I guess if it wasn't your name, then I don't know. Maybe I'm just looking into it too much. But yeah, the game's slow to start, but once you get going, yeah, it kind of sucks you in. Just like, but Bioshock, you sort of, I know I did the Bioshock the other day, and it is a lot faster to keep going, or a lot faster pacing. And you know, the PS2 graphics, I mean, they don't really seem too bad here, but the controls, again, yeah, actually, they're not too bad, I gotta say, because the Resident Evil used to piss me right off. It's so fucking robotic. You're just like, Mr. Roboto, you know, I'm like, what the hell? Now, here's where they do a really good job with the design of the game. The sound effects, you know, the first time I walked down this path, you know, scare the shit out of yourself. And, you know, before I just keep walking, you know, if you're going to play this game, one of the rules, I'm going to set the rule here, you have to play this by yourself in the dark, okay? You can't fucking play this in the daytime. It should be illegal. And if you play this with other people, I mean, that's fine, but you really need to scare the shit out of yourself a little bit, because that's the whole appeal of the game. Don't wuss out, trust me. It's awesome. So we're walking down this path backwards. I mean, the camera is positioned this way to give you this sense of unease as you hear these odd sound effects. You know, it was very jumpy when I started playing this game. But, yeah. Suffice it to say, I'll, you know, break the thick air and say that nothing really happens here. Even though you think it might. You know, the fog effects, you know, it just happens to be foggy outside at the moment, actually. It's kind of funny. So I thought it was a perfect opportunity to break out of this game and play it. After, like, I don't know, so many fucking years. It's ridiculous how long I've let, you know, how much time I've let pass before I try to play this and do a YouTube video on it. It really does set a wonderful tone, though. Like an eerie, eerie tone. Okay, see the way the camera's pulling in. You know, sort of trying to get going. Come on, James, move your ass. Let's go. So it takes a while to get up to speed. And I think what this does is set up the sense of isolation, the sense of mystery, the sense of, like, envelopment. Like, this town has a hold on you. And it just kind of opens up over time. You see the camera changing again. It's kind of like a story. Sort of a director touch, I guess. And the music getting kind of ominous, setting the tone for the town as you get closer to it. Of course, you can't even see in front of your face now. Go ahead and get the chainsaw. If I think, no, it's not in there. Okay, never mind. Yeah, I forgot all the details, but we'll save it, I guess. Because, So the red cards become your saves, kind of like the ink ribbons from the Resident Evil series. I find the controls are actually quite, they're not bad. You know, I mean, it's just sort of when you get into the combat, it becomes a little harder. And again, the music, the sound effects, I think are really well done. Again, changing the perspective, so you're feeling uneasy, you're walking backwards, like you could trip and fall on your ass, you know. A lot of elements, you can tell there's a lot of thought that went into this game, even though it does look deceptively simple. Again, feeling of isolation, there's not much going on, sense of unease.